Hey, how's it going, everybody, and welcome back to the channel. So if you're new to the channel, my name is Big Ball Vlogs. I do reviews, news, everyday vlogging, and every once in a while I'll do a tutorial. If this video is educational or somewhat entertaining, please consider smashing that like button and maybe subscribing to the channel for new videos when I post them. So today, I wanted to jump back into talking about the DJI Mavic Air 2. I'm going to focus today specifically on the camera features and maybe give you some tips on how to get, you know, the best bang for your buck when it comes to a photo without really understanding how to use a camera in manual mode. First off, before we get into everything, I thought I would go through the settings and try to explain what each one does. Let's go down the line of different photo modes. Single shot is going to allow you to kind of go in and just take that single photo. The next one is going to be your 48 megapixels. It's going to give you a much bigger image. If it comes to storage, or if you're worried about the amount of storage you have on your memory card, a 48 megapixel photo is going to be four times as big as a 12 megapixel photo. The next one down again is smart. I did a lot of different shots. Let's take a quick look at some of the images that I got. So this was a quick shot that I took in smart mode. And as you can see, the clouds have some contrast to them. There's some definition. You got some solar flare coming off the sun. And you even got a little bit of the ground, which is exposed. So you don't have that super dark ground. I can see the shine off the top of the buildings. I think this is a pretty good photo. Now, if we look at the 48 megapixel photo, same image, same position, same camera shot. Haven't moved anything. As you can see, the ground is a little bit darker. You can still see the shine coming off the top of the buildings, but look at the clouds, look at the sun. They're all blown out now. The smart photo option was able to kind of clean that image up and give me the perfect shot. And that's exactly what I was looking for. I was looking for the solar flare that I could see with my eye coming through the sun, of the sun coming through the clouds. And the smart option got that image without me having to do any type of correction. Look at the ground and everything, the color, the contrast in smart photo. You're still getting the detail in the sky, and you still got a lot more detail in the ground smart option. And I like it. Now, this is the 48 megapixel version. Again, sky blown out, ground extremely dark. And this was an image I just wanted to get of the clouds. Now we're looking at the smart photo. Look at the detail in the clouds on this one. And you still get a lot of detail on the ground. If I go to the 48 megapixel, the cloud detail has kind of, you know, faded out. It's got a little bit soft. The ground looks okay, but it's just not that great of an image. So let's start with the 48 megapixel version of this. This camera was able to pull out some very good detail at night. It actually pulled out the grass, and it pulled out a lot of the lighting, and it lit up this whole development. You can actually see the stripes in the grass. Now, if I go to the smart image here, you can see how it kind of bumped up the sky. There is a lot less noise in this image. So even for a night shot, this image looks absolutely amazing. I can see the detail in the streets, I can see the detail in the sky, and I don't have a lot of noise from it pumping up that ISO to the point where the image looks grainy. The smart option gives me a lot more contrast in the ground. I think it gives me a little bit more saturation, and to me, it gives me an image that's more appealing to my eye. When it comes to images, photos, and video, it's all into the eye of the creator. If you want to get the best image quality on that one shot, if you only got one shot, I would suggest that you use the smart option in your camera settings. I did a lot of shots, and every image that I took with the smart option was the image that I chose to save for posting to social media. Tell me what you think below. And thanks for watching and supporting the channel. I'll talk to you later. Bye.